So what in the world is a reproductive endocrinologist, or RE as they're sometimes called? I mean, they're doctors, right? Yeah, but they're not just doctors, they're baby expert doctors. Let's talk about them. What's up? My name is Corlandos Scott, and I am an assisted reproductive technologies attorney based in Los Angeles. And that means that my entire practice revolves around working with REs to help people grow their families through assisted reproduction, like surrogacy, egg donation, sperm donation, all that good stuff. And a question I often get is, well, I'm thinking about needing fertility treatments, and I hear these things called reproductive endocrinologists. What are they anyway? So in this episode, we're going to look at what they are, what they do, and why you may need one. Let's jump into it. So what are REs? Some of you may know them as fertility doctors. They're the doctors that people who can't have a baby or who are having trouble having a baby or who want to have a baby go to. And that's their official title. It's reproductive endocrinologists, or as I said, you hear them referred to as REs. But what is a reproductive endocrinologist? Well, I did the homework for you. I'm not one, but I did a little digging for you. And based on what I understand, this is what an RE is. Simply put, an RE is a fertility doctor who specializes in the endocrine system. Okay, I'm gonna take my best crack at this. Don't judge me though. So the endocrine system is the system of glands, and these glands create hormones, and these hormones help cells communicate with each other, and they're responsible for almost every cell, organ, and function in your body. They deal with the problems originating in and or involving puberty, pregnancy, and stress. Phew, I think I kind of got it. So if I have any REs watching, correct me if I'm wrong, leave a comment, let me know. But what exactly do REs do? If they're fertility specialists, aren't they the same as OBs or OB-GYNs? Well, sorta. As I understand it, REs are first OB-GYNs. Reproductive endocrinology is a subset or subspecialty of obstetrics and gynecology. But slow down, being an OB-GYN doesn't automatically make you an RE. Let's make that clear. So what do REs do then? Again, from what I've gathered in my research, because I did the homework for you, this is what they do. They can diagnose blood sugar and thyroid abnormalities. They can run semen tests. They can order an X-ray of the uterus and the fallopian tubes to check for problems. They can perform an ovarian reserve test to measure the level of various hormones related to reproduction. They can also do or administer follicle stimulating hormones. Here's where it gets good for us. They can diagnose various infertility problems, and they can perform various infertility treatments like IUI and IVF. Maybe you're watching and you aspire to be a reproductive endocrinologist one day, so you're wondering, how do I get there? Well, the first step is education and training, and that usually starts with a science-based bachelor's degree before med school. Then they take place after med school in a residency program and get certified as an OB-GYN. After that, most of them complete a fellowship in reproductive endocrinology and infertility. You'll sometimes see the acronym REI. That's what that is. Next, they have to pass a written and oral exam to become a board certified RE. Phew, man. Well, now I see why when I get around all of my RE buddies and I start complaining about what law school was like, they kind of look at me with the side eye like, dude, give me a break. It's a pretty rigorous process, but that's great because what they're able to do is change people's lives forever with their skill set. But before we talk about why you may need to see an RE, I want you to do something for me. Let me know what inspired you to even click on this video in the first place. I'm always interested to hear people's stories and how you got to this position. I'd love to offer any advice and help that I can, and maybe even be able to connect you with a reputable RE. All right, let's look at reasons why you may need to see an RE. Okay, again, I'm no doctor, but I actually went to ask one about this. Why would you need to see an RE? Well, number one, problems with menstrual cycles or periods, whether you're trying to have a baby or not. Also, if you've had one or more miscarriages, no matter how careful you try to be during each pregnancy, that may be a reason to go see an RE. Also, infertility treatments, both male and female, if you're looking towards that, then you want to go see an RE. you also may need to see an RE for a diagnosis around potential endometriosis symptoms like painful periods or pelvic pain or even cramping around the menstrual cycle time. And this is a serious thing because if it's left untreated, this could lead to infertility or even subfertility, which is just the reduced ability to become pregnant. You also may need to see an RE to obtain or to look into a diagnosis for polycystic ovary syndrome, or PCOS as it's known. This is a condition that affects a woman's hormone levels. Now, women with PCOS produce higher than normal amounts of male hormones. The imbalance causes women to have irregular menstrual periods or to skip a period altogether. Now, this makes it difficult for women to get pregnant. And the last thing on my list of why you may need to see an RE is simply to get pregnant, and specifically to get pregnant if any of these things are present. Problems with sexual function, problems in the testicle area, abnormal breast growth, and a lower than normal sperm count. I should probably get a t-shirt that says, "I love REs," because I really do. They make my job and my practice area possible. Reproductive endocrinologist is not just a fancy and additional title for doctors to throw around. They play a huge and integral part in every person or couple's goal of having a baby. REs don't just identify, diagnose, and tell you why you're having reproductive issues or problems like male or female infertility, PCOS, and all the other issues affecting one's ability to have a baby. REs are the only type of doctor with specialized training focused solely on helping people become and stay pregnant. So if you're planning to have a baby and it looks like there's a bit of a problem, check with your OB-GYN, then go see a reproductive endocrinologist. If you're looking to see a reproductive endocrinologist and you're looking for tips on how to choose the right one, make sure you click the link below and get access to my surrogacy methodology called the 3 T's of Successful Surrogacy. In those 3 T's, the first T is team, and I talk about how to assemble your right team, including the right doctor for your fertility journey. So click the link below, get access to it, and I'll see you in the next episode.